Cry the Bee in Bar, north of Criminal Scum and the Rift. Say we grab a thief, and break his legs, and leave him in the market for the crows to feast on. The rest will scatter into the sewers like rats.
Yes? Yes?
Lizard, this town is rife with lawbreakers. What leads can you offer?
Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter.
It looks like we have new prey to catch. This one is an especially loathsome lawbreaker. Ah, Kwama. This one is better served as a surprise. It's a bit gruesome, which will make it all the more sweeter when he screams. He was last seen in East March. But a fetcher on the run doesn't stay at the Kandahar Pole. There's an old inn to the west of that place. 100 gold crowns says that's where he'll be. your name, Griffith?
Who wants to know?
Your swords, lawbreaker. Pray to them for mercy when I carve out your flesh.
I'd like to see you try.
No!
Out of the way, child. Your guardian is a killer, and my knives beg to lick his throat.
He's not a killer. He's my father.
Morgan.
Tell him. Tell him my pa's not a killer.
Well, what of it? Do you know this little Quama? Why does she vouch for this killer? So if the murderer has a child, it grants him the liberty to kill. Your words are nonsense, Fetcher. They crumble before they leave your lips. This ugly son of the Guar, my knives will drink him fast, then slow.
Dog, you're gonna need a bigger bandage to cover up that ogre you call a face.
Stop it! Stop fighting! You promised you would only kill the monsters, like Gavinia.
Wait. That name... Where did you hear it?
It's the monster who hurt him. Griffith only kills monsters.
Quiet, kid. It's nobody's business but ours.
It's too late now, sweet. Better come clean. This man... Gavinia. How do you know his name?
I just do.
So you say. But the hate in your eyes, I know it well. You hunt this man. Seven months ago, one of my witnesses told me of a wagon full of contraband that was being delivered to Solitude. I tracked it down, ambushed the carriage, and held the driver for questioning. The man was well trained. The wheels of the wagon could have rusted with blood before he spoke. But I knew his cargo would speak for him. I thought it was skooma. What I found was slaves. Their tongues were cut out, so they could not speak. It was wishful thinking to think that they could write, but I asked anyway. And then, that's when one of them, no more than a child, pointed to a name scrawled on the boards in blood.
Gavinia.
Right, Fetcher. That's him. Your prey is my prey.
Yeah? So what does that make us?
It doesn't make us friends, Sweet. But I will say this. The bounty in my hand is for a child killer. And so long as this girl lives, perhaps it's the Jarl who's mistaken. But I have my eye on you. Don't think for a second our business is over.
I wouldn't dream of it. You've been awfully quiet. I wasn't sure what to think of this. You bringing this maniac here. I can tell he's not with the Brotherhood, though. But that won't guarantee Morgan's safety. Maybe. I got a lead. Whispers mostly, but when it comes to that name, I've been trained to listen. That's what I've been thinking about. I can't leave her alone, and I can't bring her with me. And if it's one or the other, him or her, it will always be her. It wasn't something I wanted to do, but I had to. Because of where my head was at, I couldn't trust my own decisions. You know why I have to do this. Why I can't let him live. But she didn't. And as she always does, the girl asked why. So I told her. And if my needs ever made her feel unsafe, to let me know. That's another reason Gavinia has to die. I can't protect Morgan like this. Not when all I see are the faces from that day.
If you are done talking, I would like to start interrogating. What do you know?
Shut your mouth and I'll tell you, one eye. As a drifter, you get an earshot of all sorts of crazy rumors. You hear the same one enough, and you start paying attention. The one I heard was about a rich baron using the war as a way to gain influence with the new jarls, or the weakened ones. Turns out, the whole plan wasn't going too well, and our baron was more than a bit agitated. So he decided to get on his ship and sail to Windhelm. That ship is now docked at the harbor.
And so what? You and the girl are going to raid that ship by yourself. A wealthy baron can buy a lot of cell swords. What if he's smart, a few good ones?
You're afraid of Merc's elf? Because I'll go through 1,000 cell swords to kill that bastard.
You may not be, Fincher, but I imagine the child is. I can tell this man means more to you than he does to me. But someone has to stay.
I've thought of that, but I don't trust anyone to protect her but me.
Then we have a problem, sweet. You can't be in two places at once. Unless you have a better idea, I will protect the child.
Not a chance. There's gotta be another way. What do you think? No. Absolutely not. You're right. Maybe I'm not thinking clearly on this either. If that's what's best for Morgan, then okay. Honestly, I was going to suggest you stay. But then that would leave me with him. It wouldn't be pretty. Gavinia is too paranoid to leave his ship. It's likely he had people delivered to him. But don't get any ideas. I'm not wearing a noble's clothes. What I'm saying is we'll have to sneak our way past the guards. Either that or muscle our way in. Morgan, I'm gonna be gone for a little while, like we talked about.
Don't worry, Pa. I'll be okay. Hugo get the bad monster.
It'll just be for a little while, I promise. If anyone comes near, stay behind the elf.
I don't like him.
That makes two of us, kid. But he'll keep you safe.
Alright, I'll do my best.
Good girl.
The child will be safe, Inma. But the same can't be said for you. Good luck.
What? Yes. I was a young boy, living in an old cottage with my parents and older sister. She was about 5 years older than Morgan, and promised to marry. It was the day of her wedding, when Lord Gabania's men came riding in the field. Some call it the rite of first night, as if men of power needed to justify their rape with laws. No, they just took what they wanted. Two of Gabania's men were dragging my sister into the cottage when they passed me by. One of them turned and looked at me, and her eyes met. There wasn't a drop of emotion on that face. That's what I remember most from that night. Not the murder, or the rape, or the screams. It was the face of that guardsman. The face of apathy. That I couldn't forgive.
And you think this absolves you of your crimes, murderer? Is it this the one to blame? Gabalia? Or the gods? When life poisoned my body, I burned it out. If you cannot do the same, it will eat you alive.
I don't need to kill anyone. But those men, the people who stand by and do nothing, while all around them the world suffers. They're better off dead, and I'm the one to kill them.
So, Who is it that you hate, Fetcher? Who is your true prey? Is it Gabania? Or this guardsman?
You don't get it. That face. They all wore it. The people I killed for the Brotherhood. They wore it too. Gabania. His men. And everyone I've killed since. To me, they're all one and the same.
Dunmer females are harlots. Lucifer and a Bellin priest. I'm surprised I wasn't born with scales. You ever hear about Beren Zion theories? There is a reason they call that tavern in Rivdin the Bee and the Barb. And what's that? You are confusing the laws of priests with that of mortals. It wasn't a crime when Beren Zion bed a cat, but it was foolish of her to bed a thief. That's what I meant, Scream. If I said Skyrim was cold, it doesn't mean that there are no summer days. Don't you ever hear about Beren's Eye? I've had my fair share, Fetcher. Never saw what all the fuss was about. Until I tried the other half. In any case, I don't hold it against them. Azura is strong in her females. And Azura gets what she wants. Their desire for flesh is like a cat's desire to steal. But only one violates the law. You blind scream. Last time I checked, I didn't have any fur on my back. Just on my blades.
I'll be fine. Don't worry. Oh, I'm not falling for that again. He is! He's like a father, and an uncle, and a granddad, rolled in one. Yeah, I'm going to be a mage someday. I just don't have a book to learn any spells. Sense. This is going to really help with the cooking. I heard someone around here say you needed an extra one. I'll be fine. Don't worry. I am strong. Someday I'll be as strong as Griffith. Then we'll fight monsters together.
Yes. Take care.
I'm getting out of here.
The way these ships are designed, the captain's quarters are on the lower deck. We'll probably have to fight our way down.
You're not supposed to be here.
Don't worry. In a minute we'll be gone. And you'll be dead.
What was that?
I told you, idiots, I didn't want to be disturbed.
It was 20 years ago. There was a small town in Cyrodiil that blended into the countryside. My father always joked it was too small to be on any map. And when the visitors came by, they felt like explorers, discovering the town for the first time. But for me, it was the only place that felt like home. Yet after that day, I realized the whole thing was just a ruse. You made those maps, and you never put our town there for a reason.
Of course it would be you.
So you do remember?
Don't be absurd. I haven't the slightest idea what you're talking about. I don't know who you are, but I know what you are, and I know what you are not. In my time, I have challenged jarls and kings, armies and empires. I've been targeted by everyone from the Brotherhood to the remnants of the old Morag Dom. I challenged the gods themselves, and neither Daedric Prince nor the makers of the realm could fell me. Of course it was you, boy. The others were not so foolish. Nor were they as brave.
I've waited my entire life for this moment.
As have I, boy. Don't disappoint me now.
I should have figured he wouldn't remember. They never do. Worried. We better hurry back. Right now, I just want to make sure Morgan's okay.
Something.
The Dark Brotherhood. What happened?
Nothing. Just one of your murderer friends stopping by to say hello. It wasn't long before I had to say goodbye.
Morgan, are you alright?
I'm fine. Uncle Rains was mean to the monster, but I think he's really just shy.
Maybe you're right. Looks like she's gonna be okay. Best we stay clear of Windhelm and each other. That goes for your friend as well. Unless he wants to try to collect on that bounty.
What bounty, Fetcher? The Jarl doesn't put a price on the head of brooding fathers. But there may come a time when the girl won't be around to save you. Then we'll meet again.
I'll be waiting.
We did good work taking care of Cabana. Lawbreak is from here to seal deal would know they are unsafe. Not at all. The assassin was distracted. For only one of us had a stake in the child's life.
Help you.